News review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we give you the language from the latest news stories and tell you how to use it in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Neil. Joining me today is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hello, Neil. Hello, everybody.
So, what's our story?
Today we're going to Africa for a health story.
Okay, let's find out more about that African health story from the BBC World Service.
To great excitement in Malawi, where the first large-scale pilot of the malaria vaccine is launched later today. Basically, Malawi is going to start using the vaccine as part of its routine immunisation programmes for children. Ghana and Kenya follow soon.
So, a good news story here. There is a new drug which is being tested from today, and the drug is going to prevent people from catching malaria. Now, malaria is a very serious disease. It kills about 1,200 people every day, mostly children under five in Africa. So if this drug is successful, it's a good news story indeed.
Okay, well, you've been looking at this story and the language being used around it. You've picked out three words, and what are they?
We have pilot, groundbreaking, and campaign.
Pilot, groundbreaking, and campaign. So, your first headline with that word pilot, please.
Yep, we have the Mail Online. The headline is Malawi to pilot groundbreaking malaria vaccine.
So, pilot, test to see if something works before making it more widely available.
That's right. Now, nothing to do with the person who flies a plane. That person's job is a pilot, but we're not talking about planes or flying here. Pilot has the sense here of trying something new to see if it works. Mm-hmm. In this case, we're testing this vaccine amongst a relatively small group of people. If it's successful, it'll be used with more and more people.
Okay, so it sort of carries that sense of guiding the way in a new direction.
If you want to relate it to planes and flying, if that helps you remember, yeah, a pilot on a plane guides the plane, and this pilot as a test will guide the future of this particular drug.
Okay, and we can use it as a verb and a noun in this sense.
Yes, you can pilot a new product, or you can have a pilot of a new product, yeah.
Yeah, and it's used more widely. We're not just talking about drugs or things like that.
No, as I said, new products. It can also, often we use it in media. Mm. If a television company or radio company or will make a test, one program, they'll show it to the audience. If the audience like it, they'll make more of the same. If they don't like it, they won't. Now, that first program is called a pilot, and they use that to pilot the series.
Okay. It sounds a little bit to me like English for Cats.
English for Cats, yes, you know, your baby.
We had this great idea.
You.
For ages. And then we actually thought we'd make a program, a pilot. And then based on the success of that.
Or not.
We've decided not to make any more.
Yeah, indeed, yes. And that's the purpose of a pilot.
Okay, let's move on to our next headline.
Okay, so now we're looking at Japan Times. Malawi to test groundbreaking malaria vaccine.
Groundbreaking, using new innovative methods.
Okay. Yes. So this one is a very literal expression. If we think about first building, if you're going to make a new building, the first thing you have to do, one of the very first things you have to do, is actually break the ground. You come along with machinery, you make a hole in the ground, you put in the foundations, the base of the building.
Yeah.
So something's groundbreaking, it's new, mm-hmm. simply.
Okay, so it's got a very literal original meaning, breaking ground to build something new.
Yeah.
Here we're using it figuratively.
Yes, here we're using it about a vaccine for malaria, but anything that's never been done before, and it can be described as groundbreaking. You can have groundbreaking music, you can have groundbreaking transport systems, you can have groundbreaking ideas. It's mm-hmm. just about innovation, newness, progress, and usually in a very positive sense.
Yeah, BBC Learning English, groundbreaking in its approach to English language.
We try to be.
OK, let's have a look at our final headline, please.
Yep, final headline comes from Deutsche Welle. Africa begins world's biggest anti-malaria vaccine campaign.
Campaign. Organised activity aimed at creating change. Now, the first thing to say about campaign is a really weird-looking word.
It doesn't sound the way you spell it. So the spelling is C-A-M-P-A-I-G-N. But when the pronunciation, please model it for us.
Campaign.
Very, very silent G.
There's no G going on in there.
No, no campaign. It's campaign. It's a noun, and it basically talks about activities that you do in order to achieve a change. And often when you campaign, because it's a verb and a noun, you do things which make people aware of something and makes them change their behaviour.
Yeah. So, for example, in advertising.
Often in advertising campaigns, when you can advertise a product, or you often talk about a campaign to promote a new movie. So a new movie is released, you'll see posters of it everywhere, you see trailers, short clips of the movies, the actors will be giving interviews on the television, maybe some fast food people will give you free tickets. All of those activities together are a campaign.
And you can have a political campaign.
When politicians want to get elected, you see the posters, you see the leaflets through your door, people on radio advertising, and all of that, again, is a campaign. The aim of the campaign is to be elected. So the campaign will have an aim, and that is for people to do something differently.
For example, in London over Easter, there's been a big environmental campaign.
Yes, lots of activity from the environmental groups asking people to change their behaviour regarding the environment.
OK. And a person who is involved in a campaign is?
A campaigner, with an ER on the end.
Absolutely. Can you now give us a recap of today's vocabulary, please?
Most definitely. We had pilot, test to see if something works before making it more widely available. We had groundbreaking, using new innovative methods. And we had campaign, organised activity aimed at creating change.
Yes, indeed. If you would like to test yourself on today's vocabulary, there's a quiz that you can take on our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where you can find all kinds of other videos and activities to help you improve your English. Thank you for joining us, and goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.
Hi, thanks very much for watching our video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm sure you did. Don't forget to subscribe. We've got lots and lots of really, really good content on our channel and all sorts of programs for a wide variety of English language learning. That's it. We'll see you very soon. Bye.